There is a building with unusual architecture in one of the most beautiful places of Moscow, on Vorobyovy Gory. Bluebird sculpture is seated at the very top of it. This symbol of happiness, together with a harp, became a trademark of the Moscow State Academic Children's Musical Theater named after Natalya Sats. The performances of this creative troupe are well known not only to the Russian audience. Every day, this hospitable house is opened for young and adult audiences. Its repertoire includes about 30 operas and ballets staged on the best plays of the Russian and world classics and musical plays of modern composers. Having entered this theater, its visitors deepen in a magic world created by careful human hands, who considered that people should be familiar with great art, art of music, from the very early age. This person was the founder of the theater, Natalya Sats. Nowadays, her honorable deed is continued by her pupils and successors.
Сегодня, когда театру уже более 40 лет, и когда каждый день
Today, when the theater is already more than 40 years old and more than 1,000 people come there every single day, it is great to say that Natalya Sats' idea hasn't been forgotten. It is alive in the performances of this theater, in opera actors and orchestra musicians' creative work. It is alive in creative work of all those people who take part in the staging of performances. Welcome to our theater. One of the latest performances of this theater is a ballet by a fairy tale written by a famous Italian writer, Jenny Roderi, Cipollino. Karen Hachaturian wrote the music for it, and a famous choreographer, Henry Majorov, made the ballet. It is a very specific theater, as it is engaged in the creation of repertoire for children, teenagers and youth. And our performance suits its repertoire range very well. I liked working with this troupe very much because it was plastic, energetic and bright. And we managed to stage a good performance. It is not quite suitable to praise myself, but in this case everything is clear from the audience's demand. When the theater is full, it means everything is fine. A new day comes and a usual everyday work starts in the theater. Rehearsals, ballet classes and vocal lessons. A creative troupe of the ballet is traditionally young, but it can stage very serious and complex performances as the actors are assisted by teachers and tutors, among whom there are famous dancers of the past. The opera troupe of the theater includes honored and public actors of the Russian Federation and laureates of international competitions. The main hall of the theater comprises 1,100 spectators, and its stage space is unique. The main stage can be transformed in three stages, In combination with the most modern equipment, it allows to implement scale projects. There is also a small hall in the theater. Now they're staging a ballet by Snegurochka, Snow Girl, play of the Russian literature classic Alexander Ostrovsky. Decorations are being made by the sketches of the artist Ksenia Shimanovich. The spectators of Snegurochka will see bright and colorful play, and surely costumes made by the theater masters will be an important part of this performance. The music to the new performance was composed by Vladimir Sokolov. Its staging was realized by famous choreographer Ivan Fadeyev.
История с постановкой «Снегурочка» очень интересна, потому что совпало сразу несколько...
The history of the ballet «Снегурочка» staging is very interesting, as it is based on several happy moments. It happens in the theater with young audience. It is written by a living composer who can explain every note, and the actors feel their significance in the story. And I hope that the very theme, ethno, can be revealed and represented to any spectator of this performance.